Okay, I'm here, E3, day three, with Will Flanagan from...
Frontend Events. I'm the community manager at...
Who's just told me I've missed David Braben.
You've missed David Braben. He was here yesterday. He's not here right now.
Because Frontier have confused us by transforming Elite into Jurassic Park.
Yes, this is our third game out of Elite Dangerous and Planet Coaster. This is the third arm. It's Jurassic World Evolution, and it's out this week. It released 2 days ago.
Not even this week. It's 2 days ago.
2 days ago, yeah.
You guys are amazing.
We're on form.
That's one thing I noted with Elite. You got the alpha, you got the beta, yeah. And it just came out.
Same with this, we released 2 days ago for E3. What we've got here is a recreation of the original Jurassic Park Jeep. These are from lovely guys who do up cars and 4x4s and recreate cars from the series. Now along here is our enclosure.
Which is high voltage, so we won't touch it.
Don't touch that. We have a raptor in there as well. We've got awesome.
And the guy touched it.
And the guy touched it. He was fine. I could have done a thing from the movie when the guy's. They're joking.
And they're usually kids. Spielberg does stuff to kids in films.
Oh, yeah?
He uses them as emotional
props.
Well,
yeah, I can see how that's.
Effective. Little Velociraptor.
We have a raptor here. Scary looking raptor.
So this is a raptor. Really?
Watch it.
Hey, that eye is following me. It's day three.
It's day three. So here are the impressive Jurassic
let's,
World
let's
games.
Step back and get yeah, the yeah. full effect in 3D. I seriously hope you don't have to put all this stuff away.
No, I don't personally. We have a lovely team. From MB who are working on this.
I particularly like the flames.
They're nice. They're a nice little touch.
Yeah.
But if you think these gates are awesome, come and look at this that I have to show you.
Okay.
So we're moving into the enclosure now.
Best David Attenborough voice.
Thank you. Oh, I don't think I can do one anymore. I'm hoarse after
3 days of
yeah. 3 days of talk demo. So in there is where people can come and play the game. They get a short introduction from an actor. And we'll go in there very soon. But I want to show you this. This thing is very cool.
Okay.
You can hear the music that is playing out. We have custom PS4 and Xbox One consoles that are themed Jurassic World Evolution. They are very, very cool. And everyone who's come to play the game, to try it out, has been entered in with a chance to win one of these.
Wow.
We only have a few to give away, so they're very impressive. So yeah, this is the sort of outside of our enclosure. Let's go in and let's play. Let's show you some of the game.
Jurassic World.
We may have to loop round. That's very dark in there. I believe.
True.
It's quite dark in here.
Yeah. Darkness is fine.
Darkness is fine.
Adds to the atmosphere.
Emerging from there. Right. So let me. Very kindly.
Everyone at home has just limboed under that.
Great, it's wonderful. So spooky, spooky. So if you keep your heads
still. Making New World Plus one of the best dinosaur parks the world has ever seen. Everything is completely safe, as I've stated previously. Anyway, as new members of the Hammond Foundation, you'll be starting with a training mission set within Jurassic World Evolution. Why evolution, you might ask? Well, as many of you know, in addition to the amazing strides we've made in DNA research and gene manipulation and reconstruction, we are always looking to evolve our facilities. We want our guests to have the experience of a lifetime, memories that survive as long as they do, which will be a long time, obviously. Everything is perfectly safe. Any rumors to the contrary are just rumors. So, on the helicopter ride in, you may have noticed that the Jurassic World complex is actually comprised of 5 individual islands off the coast of Costa Rica.
And here we enter, this is where the E3 public can come and play the game that is already out, but they can come and play and give it a go.
People are running into the jet with them. Oh my god.
And can you tell us a bit about the game?
Yeah, the Jurassic World Evolution is a management simulation game where you are tasked to build your own Jurassic World. It's set across the five islands of death. Cerros, Sorna, Pena, Nata, Nublar. I'm forgetting one of them. There's a lot of deaths, a lot of islands, a lot of dinosaurs.
We
all love dinosaurs. So the aim of the game is to build the most successful Jurassic World as possible. And with that, you have a lot of tools at your disposal. You have buildings where you can manage your guests. You send out dig teams to collect fossils, create various dinosaurs. And as you can see, we have a T-Rex right there. So it's created from genomes and fossils that you've collected from across the world.
How much micromanagement?
You can really get in depth with the management of the buildings, setting prices, sort of setting needs for your dinosaurs as well. Every dinosaur has a lot of needs, from comfort levels. They need a certain amount of trees, a certain amount of grassland, food, water, and some of them also get sick as well. Now, one of my favorite elements is that you are managing what at first seems like a very idyllic, serene, calm Jurassic World, but eventually things will start to go wrong as storms ravage your park and dinosaurs break out and there are power outages, and you have to manage all of this while still maintaining
the
sanctity of the park.
You've married the top-down RTS with...
Yes, we've also, as you can see right now, we've incorporated a third-person view, and you can actually switch this camera to get a first-person view as
awesome.
Well.
Awesome.
Yeah. In the gyrospheres, so you can
really get down with
the dinosaurs. What would you add?
A VR mode so you can feel the height of the dinosaurs.
It would be very cool.
You don't have to have the whole game VR, you just have like a...
Just that one.
No, you just have a section inside the park, which is VR, so you go into the holodeck,
see it.
Hop on your headset.
It's a very cool idea.
And walk around.
Yeah.
Oh my god, I trapped people inside.
So, did your work on Planet Coaster help with this?
Definitely, yeah. Working on Planet Coaster sort of taught us a way to build a management game as well, because it's about managing your own sort of theme park, amusement park, and we've taken some of the lessons we learned from that and changed it too. Planet Coaster, of course, is focused on creativity, creating every individual piece, and this is more a management game. This is more focused on putting down buildings and getting dinosaurs into your park.
And it will be like SimCity-style disasters happening all over the place.
Yeah.
Volcanoes blowing up.
Yeah, we have storms currently in this building game that rampage through the island and break fences, and then dinosaurs break out, and you have to get control of them. So it's very much focused on the management rather than the creative building.
So, can I be candid and ask you a question?
Yes, sure.
Have you been getting a lot of stick from the Elite fans for making a dinosaur game?
No, I mean, I think.
Or is that just our type of humour?
I think they understand that as a video game company,
you've got to make more things.
We make other games as well, and
that supports the
all of our products. And it's just because we're making Jurassic World Evolution
doesn't mean we're leaving you.
Yeah, it doesn't mean we just forget about Elite. We're still very committed to.
We still love you.
Yeah, we still love Elite. Of course, I work more extensively on Elite than I do Jurassic World and Planet Coaster, so I can empathise with that. But no, I can reassure them that it's not the case.
Yeah, because I tell you, I would love to see VR incorporated, because that's what happened with Elite. Because when we had the Alpha, there was no VR, so I made it VR, because you can make it 3D and then use headsets and stuff. Even made it AR with AR HMD.
Oh my god. Do you play it in VR now?
Yeah.
Yeah, nice.
Because it was the thing that was being showed at Gamescom with the HTC Vive. And Chet Palicek was raving about it, that he hadn't got any work done because he was playing this game called Elite Dangerous in VR. But yeah, I could definitely not have the whole game in it.
Just an area.
An area. So if people... Oh, I forgot the platforms.
So the platforms are PC, PS4, and Xbox One. And the PC version on Steam can be played with both a keyboard and a mouse, and a controller if necessary. So we have all the controls integrated.
Amazing. Well done. This is like the most awesome...
Awesome, thank you so much for saying that.
Shall we exit?
Yes, we can go through this area here. Take you through the final part of the tour. Just over here to our exit. It's our restricted area where all our dinosaur management staff work.
Dinosaur management? At least you didn't have to dress up as a dinosaur.
You know, I wouldn't have minded. I would have liked that.
I think I've seen one around.
Yeah, there is one around. somewhere here. It was sort of scalping. Here's where we do our stage demos. Times are there. I'll be back online, on stage rather, in about 10 minutes. So we'll look at some elements of the game.
So, break a leg.
Thank you so much. Thank you for having me.
Thank you for talking to us.
Yeah, no worries.
And say sorry I missed Mr. Braben, maybe next time.
Yeah, next time. Yeah.
Confusing me with dinosaur games, Adam.